In lecture, Dave pointed out that these two functions, hashTableUpdate and hashTableLookup, use some similar functionality that instead we could place in a separate procedure. Looking at the hashTableUpdate and lookup procedures here, we see code that's identical between them, namely these two lines. In both functions, these two lines of code go through a given bucket, searching for an entry whose first value is the key. And so what we're going to do is we're going to take this code and move it into a separate helper function. This is known as refactoring. Refactoring is a common software engineering practice where we change the code without changing the functionality. There's a number of reasons to do so. For example, here we're doing to minimize duplicated code. This is desirable because if we want to change how these two lines of code work, perhaps we change the structure of the bucket. We don't want to look through every hash table function searching for how this works and updating them. Rather, we just want to update it in one place. This minimizes bugs and saves time. So let's give it a try. Here, I've created a new function called bucketFind. You should see that it's very similar to the code that we have in update and lookup, in that we're going to go through the bucket, searching for the entry whose first value is the key, and then returning the entire entry so that we can use it accordingly in both update and lookup. So now that we have the helper function, let's change our hash table functions to use it. The resulting code is going to be both simpler and shorter. I've changed hash table update. We find the bucket in the first line, then within the bucket, we're searching for the key. And if we find that entry, we're going to update the value. Otherwise, we're going to append the key and the value to the end of the bucket. It looks quite a bit simpler than the original function. Let's do the same thing to lookup. In the new hash table lookup, we first find the bucket, and then within the bucket, we search for the entry. If the entry is not none, we return the second value. Otherwise, we return none.